better morning than I am. Hopefully you can hear me. I just wanted to do a video to explain where I've been. I think I said it somewhere. Sorry. Something on the screen. I think I said it somewhere the past few weeks, but I had a procedure done on my leg called Vein Ablation, and I also had ambulatory phlebectomy. Wow, I'm surprised I remembered all of that by myself. So basically what it is, they took a catheter and put it in my vein, my superficial vein, like my varicose veins, like the ones that aren't going up to your heart and everything. They're not the important ones. But since I do have a blood clot in my leg, which is in my superficial vein, it's still there, by the way, after about 6 weeks, now. Not sure if I still have the one in my lung or not. I don't even know. I know I said it maybe once in a video or twice, but at the end of July, I had a pulmonary embolism in my blood clot in my lung, and I had one in my leg. The one in my leg, I kind of knew, because it was like this much of my vein was hard when I touched it, and it was tender when I touched it, and it stayed like that for a few days, and I'm like, eh. And then, like, I found out a few years ago that I have blood clotting disorder, which is the, I'm gonna forget this one, mutation, prothrombin type 2 mutation. That's the one I have. So I have prothrombin type 2 mutation. I found that out 3 years ago when I had Colin, and my brother had a blood clot in his groin, and my doctor was flipping out, like, did you ever get tested? And so she tested me, and I have it. So, and my brother has passed away a year and a half ago now, and he never got tested for it, so we don't know if he had it or not, but he definitely had a blood clot. So, anyway, and I have not gotten Colin tested yet, but I will be, because I'd like to know, basically, if you have, I'm not sure if it's all blood clotting disorders, but if you have the one or if it's just the one that I have, but if one of your parents has it, then you have a 50% chance of having it. Is that right? Yeah. So Colin has a 50% chance of having it. And one of my parents probably has it, so they need to get tested too. Neither one of them have had a blood clot, and so, like, I think the doctor's like, well, it's not that huge of a deal to get tested if you've never had a blood clot, but it's like, if you have major surgery, like, when I had my C-section, I had to take, I had to do shots of heparin for 6 weeks, I believe, after he was born, just to prevent blood clotting. So it seems like you would want to know if you have that, so that you can prevent a clot from happening if you have surgery. And my mom has had quite a few surgeries, so I think she's going to be getting tested soon. Anyway, back to my procedure that has, well, yeah. Anyway, so I've had varicose veins since I was about 12 years old. Like, my first one kind of popped up, and then, like, in my 20s, they kind of popped up more. I have been overweight most of my life, but they are hereditary. My grandma that had really bad varicose veins was never overweight, and she had them horribly, so you can blame a lot on weight, and that's fine, and I do, but it's a hereditary thing, you know. So, like when I got my blood clot, you could blame it on me sitting on my ass all day or something, but that's not how it is. I never sit down. And I still got a blood clot. So, hereditary. Your genes have a lot to do with a lot of things. Even if you don't know it until you're an adult. Anyhow, I'm going to show you my leg. I got my first procedure done on Monday, so that was 2 days ago. It is now Wednesday morning, and I'm getting ready to go and do the other leg, the leg that actually has the blood clot in it. So I'm going to show you my leg, and I'm going to talk about the procedure a little bit, because I was told, and I was under the impression, that it would just be a few shots. And I kind of want to make this video for anybody getting this procedure done. Not to freak them out, but, and I've had a C-section, I get my finger pricked now every week to test my Coumadin level, which is the blood thinner I'm on, that I'll probably be on forever. And I've had thyroid disease, hypothyroidism, but I had Graves' disease before, so I get, you know, I have blood draws for that a lot since, and I've had that since I was about 12 or 13. I used to give blood every time I could. I used to give plasma. I'm not a stranger to a needle. Clean needles. Not those needles. But I'm very comfortable having a needle poked into me. I get the depot shot for my birth control also. That's another needle. I'm not afraid of needles, I'm not afraid of hospitals and doctors and things, you know. So, I wanted to say that first, because Monday, so I was told that, yeah, I was just going to have a few needles, you know, to numb the vein, and then they would put this catheter in my vein, like the straight veins or whatever, and they would cauterize them, so they would close the vein with heat from the laser, which is at the end of the catheter. I think I explained that right. If not, sorry. But it's something like that. And that part didn't hurt. You know, the needle pricks were whatever. To be expected, it felt like a little bee sting, you know, over here and there and now. Probably about 20-25 needle pokes. So, again, more than a few. But that was fine for me. And maybe everybody's different, and I have more veins, to do. And usually you get it done on the top and bottom part of your leg. I only got it on the bottom part. So this is like the knee, like, below the knee. This all happened below the knee. I should say that too, because apparently he did the ultrasound on my top of my leg, and he said that those veins didn't have an issue, and they weren't big. Apparently, like, when they're bigger veins, your superficial veins are bigger, that's when they have the most issues. And he said that he doesn't think that anything's, you know, going wrong from the knee up. So, he didn't do those veins, thankfully. Anyway, so, I'm a little traumatized for Monday, and I go back in 2 hours to get my other leg done, so I'm a little scared. But I wanted to film this to make sure that everybody kind of prepared, a little bit better than I did. I did have a prescription for Xanax. I did not fill it because, I didn't think I'd need it. I'm not the person that gets all worked up over things like this, and I'm still not going to take it today. Honestly, I don't think it's going to help much, you know. If I'm going to jump from pain or, you know, a surprise thing, I don't think it's going to help me. And I don't like taking stuff like that anyway, so I'm not going to take it. But if you need it, I mean, I'm not saying I hate those drugs and I think against them. I just don't think I am going to take it, even though I am scared. But if you need it, absolutely take it, because if it will help you, then definitely take it if you are getting this done. So, back to the procedure. So, numbed my leg, did the catheter. I mean, it was a little bit of pain just with the needles, and that's fine, to be expected. And then it came to the phlebectomy, which is when he puts tiny little cuts into your leg along the varicose veins, like the bulging veins. Excuse me. And then he pulls them out of that hole with, clamps and little tweezers or something. I don't know. I wanted to watch because I think it's cool. Even though it was hurting, I wanted to watch because I just think that kind of thing's cool. I really wanted to watch my C-section. It's cool to me. It's science. Our bodies are amazing, you know. I like it. So, anyway, pulled up the vein, and then snipped it off or something. I'm not exactly sure what happened because I didn't get to watch. I tried to put my head up once and he yelled at me because something about blood flow and, yeah. I guess, like, when you put your head up, it makes, like, more blood flow. And he, like, obviously, he has open veins going on right now and he doesn't want it squirting out at him, apparently. So, I had to keep my head back down. And I think he, like, pulled that whole, like, vein out or something. Like, he would make a cut and then go to a next hole and then pull that section out and then make another cut, go to the next hole, or make another hole, pull that section out, cut the vein off, something like that. Anyway, it hurt a hell of a lot when he got to, like, the outside of my leg didn't hurt. That was fine. And this was after about 20-25 more needle pokes to numb it again. So there was more needles. Again, not an issue. But it's when he was pulling on a certain area of my vein that was like I ended up crying because it hurt. And I was like gripping my shirt, and that's about all I could do, and breathing, and I've had a lot of dental work done, can't tell, be having more soon, so I've learned how to just kind of breathe through it, and just clamp down on my shirt or something, and that's how I get through stuff, and that's how I got through it, and so luckily that was at the very end, and then we were done, but it hurt a lot. I just felt like, it was more than just pressure and tugging feeling, like it hurt in a certain area. So I'm going to show you what my leg looks like now, and if you get grossed out easily, I mean, I don't get grossed out by this stuff, but if you get grossed out easily, then you can be done. That's about all I have in my story. But if you want to stick around, I'm going to show you my leg now. This is 2 days post, and I have changed my bandage twice. I took a shower yesterday, and I'll show you what I put on it. Put gauze pads on it, and this is the stuff that they put on it. Sorry, this is not all wrapped up and pretty, but this is the self-adhesive stretchy stuff, so that goes all the way around my leg, and then I put on my lovely. If you've ever worn these, you know how lovely they are. Get on and off. This is, it's inside out, sorry. But this is a compression stocking. And this is a thigh-high one. And I need to go get my knee-high ones. I got these when I was pregnant 3 years ago. And I'm using these. I was supposed to go get my knee highs, but I'm a procrastinator and I never did. And I'm like, eh, I need my thigh highs. Eh, whatever. Anyway. And then. Sorry, that was my phone. For me. Rescheduling my ultrasound for my legs. Even though my vein doctor is already doing the ultrasounds. The ultrasound is for my hematologist to see if my blood clot is still there and if I have more. Actually, I have 2 blood clots in my left leg now. I forgot about that. Yeah. My vein doctor found another one a couple weeks ago for when I did my initial ultrasound, my big long one where they like looked at everything. So, again, I'm going to show you my leg and just so you can see what it looks like because I didn't really know what it looked like. You could Google it. I Googled it after the fact, and I wish that I had taken pictures of it also, like before pictures. I'm going to take before pictures of my left leg just so I can like look back and be like, okay, that pain was worth it because my legs look better now and hopefully they'll feel better. They hurt a lot right now and I have a hard under one of the punctures done by my inner ankle, it's hard, and that's basically the one that hurts the most, although it's getting better. Like yesterday it was really bad, and walking helps. Take ibuprofen and walk. Don't stay off of it, it's just gonna hurt more. Walk on it, take your ibuprofen, and just walk on it, because it will help. I walked a lot yesterday. I went to Dollar Tree and Goodwill just to get out and stay on it. So, yes. So here we are. Here's my leg.
Okay, so here's the front. I will show you first. This right here, these are little blisters because I put this tape on to hold my gauze on, and yeah, apparently I'm allergic to it or something, I don't know. And then this right here, this hurt, this stuff right here, and I think he did that because I have it on the other side. I have this stuff going on, so I'm guessing he's going to be doing that on this side too. But the part that hurt the very most is this right here. This is the hard part. It's actually not as hard, but it's definitely tender. Colin! Tootie, I've got to wait for a minute. Don't step on my planer, man. Okay. So that part definitely hurt the most. Don't mind my disgusting heels. They are so dry and I'm just to the point where I don't care. So I had a vein going down this way. This was like a big spider vein down here. And no, there's not. This side really didn't have a whole lot done to it. Sorry, bad ankle. The angle, excuse me. And then he did one back here. And that was about it. All my varicose veins are basically on the inside of my legs. There's that one. As it went back. And then came around. It almost looks like a constellation on my leg. Anyway, and then I feel like he missed this one. This is actually, it's hard right now. And it's bruised, but there's no hole there, and I can still feel the vein. And I'm wondering about that, because this was actually my first varicose vein when I was 12. So So interestingly, and it'll be interesting if that doesn't, you know, get gone, and that's, I'm left with that one. That'll be pretty funny, because I've always had it. So then, you know, all of this is what hurt. So this is my other vein, and I've been sitting, so they really aren't popping out that bad. But I've got them back here. I've got really fat legs, by the way, if you couldn't tell. And I have really big ankles, just genetics. But it's mostly just like the spider veins down here. And then some right there. So this leg really isn't that bad. It's mostly back here. And I'll show you, right here is where my blood clot is, one of them. And then I have another one back here. So it's mostly going to be back here on this leg instead of down here. I mean, I'm going to have some down here, but it's going to be back here. So I'm anticipating it's going to hurt a lot. Again, this didn't hurt that much. It was just down here and down here. So, and I really didn't have anything done back here. So, and it hurts. It hurts a little bit when I touch it and stuff. So there's my leg. That is what you can expect. Also, some of these, they are still bleeding, but I am on blood thinner, so I guess that might not be for everybody. And some of them, like the vein, like this one right here, like actually has, like, I thought it was a scab, but I think it's like a piece of the vein hanging out, which is probably grossing you all out, and I'm very sorry, but I tried pulling on them, a couple of them have it, and it's like I came unglued because it hurt so bad. So let me turn you around again.
So that's my story. I will do an update today and let you all know how the other one does. So I will wait. I'm gonna wait to post this until after the one today. I'm not excited. 2 hours. 2 hours. And we'll see how it goes, and then I'll let you all know how it goes. Hopefully it's not as painful as 2 days ago. And then I have a follow-up appointment tomorrow, so I don't know what the heck he's doing then. I hope it's not more. Either way. Bye guys. See you in a few hours.
It is over. My trusty cat knows that I... Thank you, Griffin. Griffin gave me his sucker on my shoulder. How sweet of him. So here's my Jackie laying on my lap since I've been home, like he did on Monday. Cats are like that. If you are not a cat person, I'm sorry. He's a big brat, but I love him anyway. Oh, Jackie. I love sleepy little cats. Oh, that's nice. Alright. Let me give you an update.
I am back. It's like 4 o'clock, so I didn't just get over. I went to lunch with my mom afterwards. After my other leg, vein ablation, I really don't even know how you pronounce it, but it is over. That's all that matters, right? They found another clot, so I have 3 clots in my leg. Well, or did. I think that's how it works. I did have 3 clots. But when they were doing the ultrasound to figure out where the catheter was going to go for the laser, they found another one up in my thigh. So, again, not a deep vein thrombosis, but still flat, so, yeah. And I go Monday to get, I already said this, I think, but I'm going to say it again, but I go Monday to get all of my veins looked at to see if I have any more clots and to see if the other ones are gone, which they're not. I already know that, but my hematologist does not know that. My vein doctor knows that, but so I'm getting the, sorry, I need to put my arm down because I'm lazy. I need to get the ultrasound. This is for my hematologist. He's the one that ordered that a month or so ago. And then I'm getting the blood test, I don't remember what it's called, to make sure that the one in my lung is gone. And if not, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to be on, I don't know. Hopefully I don't have to give myself heparin shots again, because those I did for 6 weeks after Colin was born, just as a, well, any kind of shots. They almost sent me home with a different kind of shot. It wasn't heparin, it was another one. And I'm like, Lord. But they ended up just putting me on Coumadin, Warfarin, whatever you want to call it. It's the blood thinner that I'm on. And I can't eat a bunch of vegetables like I usually like to do. And I can't drink my cranberry juice like I like to do. That's like my drink. I have always drank cran grape juice with half water, and that's kind of how I keep, that's how I drink my water. I hate regular water. I can't stand it. Unless I'm like super thirsty, which I never am, so that's how I stay hydrated and keep water in my system. And I've had to get that up, and guess what? I'm dehydrated all the time now. But different story. Anyhow, today. So, the vein thing went okay. The vein ablation went okay. They put the catheter up in my leg, and this time they did my thigh. My right leg, they didn't have to go up my thigh. I think I said that to you, because the vein was so small that he didn't think that it was causing any issues, any of my issues. Or would cause any issues, so he didn't do that one. But he did it on the left side, and let me tell you what, I don't know exactly what happened, but when they turned the laser on, up on the top part of my inner thigh, which is, by the way, where your superficial veins are, it's in the inner part of your thigh, I'd show you, but my leg is wrapped about four different ways. Well, with four different things, I should say. But yeah, it started hurting when they turned the laser on, and it started hurting more. And so they shut it off. Oh no, they didn't shut it off. He just, I don't know if he put his hand over it. I don't know what happened. I couldn't see. I was laying down, but whatever it was, it went away, but I was like, okay, that was weird, what was that? And then all of a sudden, at first I thought I was smelling like burnt hair, but then I realized it was in my mouth. Like, I was tasting a burnt taste, and it wasn't gross, it was just odd. It was just odd. It's like, oh, what are we burning inside of me that I can taste? Ugh. Anyway, so, yeah. And I'm making this video, so anybody that's getting this done knows exactly what's going to happen to them. Maybe. I know everybody's different, but this is my experience. So, yeah. That happened, and then the rest of the time, I was very on edge, obviously. I'm, like, waiting for something else to hurt, or that to hurt again, or whatever. But it was fine. Nothing else was painful. There were a lot less shots this time, which is odd because they did the whole leg for the catheter. So, I don't know. Now, the second part that I had such an issue with on the right leg didn't even happen on the left leg because I didn't have any bulging veins. Yeah, I have one bulging vein, actually, right behind my knee. But, well, right under, like, on the top part of my calf, right behind my knee. But that's one of them that are one of my blood clots. So, he couldn't do that one anyway, and he said that it's just going to resolve itself with the ablation catheter, So, he said it'll just resolve itself out, and then it won't be an issue, and it won't be bulging anymore once the clot dissolves. So, yay. Yeah, and my right leg was definitely the worst, and I really wish I would have taken a picture now, a before picture, to show you guys what they did look like before. They definitely already look better, even though they have a bunch of little holes on my legs. There's one little vein that I showed you guys that was my first varicose vein, which is funny that I remember that. But tomorrow, Thursday, I have a follow-up appointment with him, and so I'm going to bring that up that day. I don't want to go through it again just for that vein. Honestly, I really don't. I will be happy if it's just that vein that's left and I don't have to get that procedure done ever again. So, yeah. So, I hope that you learned anything from my video watching it or enjoyed the story or whatever. If you have any questions, I guess, leave them below and I'll answer them. So that was my experience with vein ablation and ambulatory, which seems like a really weird word, but that's what it says on my papers. Ambulatory phlebectomy. Hopefully I will be back in my Dollar Tree. I actually went to Dollar Tree and Goodwill the other day. I did not do a haul. I'm just like, no. I might do a haul. Yeah. Half the crap we already used anyway, so. It was actually mostly gauze and ace bandages to wrap my leg, basically. That's where I went. Where else did I go? Oh, and I went to Goodwill because Nick has an interview. I had to find him some khakis that fit for his interview for a very large company that he will be making a lot of money at. And so, fingers crossed, prayers, hopes. He's unemployed right now, if you haven't noticed. I would love to get him out of my hair every day. And making some money because I'm really tired of being poor. not poor, but you know what I mean. Yeah. Worried about money every month. So, yes. Thoughts and prayers our way. His interview is next week, so. Yes. Hopefully it happens. So that's why I went to Goodwill. And I went looking for gloves for the kids, because I'm kind of low on gloves. And, you know, I like to have 3 to 4 pair for Lily, because she's constantly leaving them at school, yada, yada, yada. Lost them, whatever. They don't keep her hands warm, they get wet in the snow, whatever. I like for her to have at least 3 good waterproof pair of gloves or mittens. This should probably go in another blog, but whatever. Blog. But whatever. So anyway, I can't find gloves or mittens worth buying at Goodwill right now. Hopefully some other Goodwills have them soon. I found a really cute Justice hat though, so there's that. I'll put that in another vlog. Alright, 11 more minutes. I have no idea how long this video is going to be, and I'm sorry for pointing my finger at you. I'm sorry if it's a super long video, but as we know, I get off subject a whole lot, and yes, I'm just trying to be as informative as I can. So, thank you for watching, please subscribe. I'm going to be doing a plan with me video before next Monday at some point, and I'll be uploading that because I have not done a thing with that week yet. So we're going to be starting from scratch. I'm going to actually be doing a plan with me and doing, showing you what I'm doing as I'm doing it and not just explaining it after the fact like I did my last one, my last all of them, basically. I think I found out a way to set up my phone somehow and record it while I'm doing it. Because that's really hard. That's honestly, that's like my biggest issue, is figuring out how to set it up to film it. So look for that in the next few days. Bye.